need to know. I'll try to make another video now, more content. I guess it's about more about the body retention of certain. I'll say it first in the stomach area. I notice specifically it's the retention, where the muscle is separated from the flesh moment. It seems to have increased, and I believe it's a dehydration. However, it can't be fixed with huge amounts of water either. So it's this extra, you end up with extra, like an elephant tower. And you know, it's just this extra, and I'm like, where does it go? Because I was never like 300 pounds or anything. It's like an additional like skin found. So where does it go come from? Yeah, it's kind of depressing. It just means I have not been exercising, because I noticed immediately when I exercise, it fills in, and so I haven't been exercising, and so that's the main deal. What else does it mean? It also means that I don't know. I guess that happens. I guess that happens when you're in the situation of somebody else's living surrounds. You know, you have to kind of live in there, underneath their terms and conditions, and so it's difficult for me to continue with my where I was before, because I was dancing at the little house in France often. You know, I was dancing. I was doing also cons and arabesques, and it's all of this. This is like a forgotten that I know all about. But it's taken, what do we call it? It's taken the first body hit zone. It's not something I can just fill in with drinking water, but it is also attributed to dehydration. And as the holidays progress, you may find even more of this going on, more if you drink more. In this particular area of your body. So it's an interesting place that it happens, that it finds itself. I imagine also it finds itself in the eye tissues, jowls, and you find also with any kind of drinking, if you drink extra, you have it in your nose, it likes to puff out. What is all that about? The puffy nose syndrome. But why am I so shy out here? It's ridiculous. Ridiculous, because it doesn't help the world. I really need to relax. We actually all need to be out here in our underwears, everybody. We are way, way uptight over our body form, and shame on me for being uptight and not showing, here's, I think people are so uptight and strict that if we are going to remove, the extreme ridiculous of like, we'll take the Christian rite. We have to all get out here in our underwear and sit in a yoga position, at least go that far. You know what I mean? And women, some of you put your tops on, I guess. You may get too flagged, so maybe that'll be a peace sentiment for the world, if we can at least sit out here in our underpants for a moment or something. Because we are so body uptight here in the United States in particular. I noticed like in France, it's no big deal. You have like the advertisement woman, and she's completely naked in the shower or something. And it's no big deal. It's just the life, you know. It's a woman's body, and she's a model, and she's in the shower. And she's trying to sell us some type of a shampoo or some special soap. And that's life, you know. You look at the beautiful woman and her form, and it is not a disgrace, it is not an evil, it is not an upset, it is not something to hide away as if to wear the Mormon underwear. It is nothing like that. It is something to be appreciated and to if anything, to look forward to and want to be. So it is a good example. It's a good example to show the body woman form beautiful. The problem is there so much immaturity in association with body form naked in the man's mind that's been brought on by this type of society, here in the United States, brought on immaturity, immature men, You see a pic of a woman nude in the wrong place, you know, not at the at the bathing center, not at the swimming bath area, the swimming pool. She's wearing her bikini somewhere else. You know, it's a scandal. You know, it's like, oh, with a slut or something. You know what I'm saying? There's so much immaturity with the body, skin being shown and displayed. And I've just been giggly stupid over it also. So I apologize. So so an example, I have to chill out about it. I know I've said this before, I'm pretty sure I've even said this before. You know, if we all can just get on our Buddha underwears and just chill out and relax about it, then we won't have to be such, you know, point a finger, cast a finger, deviance at. You know what I mean? Like it is something to be ashamed of. Oh, we've heard this a lot. This is something to be ashamed of, action. They've said this a lot. And, yeah, what is all that about? Why have they said there's something to be ashamed of? Just immediately, I have to look at religion. There's nothing really to do with morality. There's nothing to do with ethics. It really does have to do with the hiding of the body that is done by many Christian religions. The hiding of the body. That sounds very serial. I know there's a lot of crime shows here on the television. I can't watch them. There's just, forget it. Yeah, a lot of crime shows. It's an odd deal, isn't it? But that's also going on. So you have the no nudity unless it's in a specific situation, or you have the these crime shows with people killing each other all the time. Yes, it's a strange. That's a more accepted. It's more accepted, and that's been applauded more over the nudity of the flesh over a beautiful woman in an advertisement or beautiful man. It's very interesting because I say applauded more because the people are watching it. People are watching it. So yeah. So apologies to certain ones out there. I know you've been out there naked for many years, and you're, well, not naked or partly naked or whatever, and then you're like, well, hello, where are the others? So yeah, apologies to you guys. I know I haven't pulled my, what do you call it, my weight, my naked weight. I've been bad that way. I've been absolutely constrained, constricted, just like, you know. They're terrible. I got a Christian right drinkling around my neck. That's the deal, you know. Yeah, that's the deal. Shame on me for that one, because it doesn't help. It doesn't help the world. Yeah, if we could tone down and relax about our bodies, just tone down about who we are and who we look like. And we don't all have to look all like dieted out and fresh, like, you know, the model, yeah, like we're the model. We don't have to look like that. It's just the point that we have such an immaturity going on, you know, a laughable about it. It's almost like, and you look at the young children also, young children are proponents of it. And it's almost like the adults are responding to the young children's bafflings. At it, you know what I mean? Yeah, they're jests. Yeah, it's almost like the adults are just like going along with it and being led by the jests of the young children. You know, well, don't show that, you know. You know what I mean? That moment, it's almost like that is how the adults are being led. It's like their bodies are not able to be seen or witnessed or had any kind of natural moment. It's only something to be, oh my gosh, you know, that, you know, over-tease, the over-flirt moment, the over-teasing and the over-flirt. Yeah. It's kind of embarrassing. Yes, it's disrespectful to our bodies, isn't it? It's disrespectful to our body. We're born into this body. Well, not you're not born into my body, but yeah, born into our bodies. And it's very disrespectful. Disrespectful to it. To jest at it. To say no, it can't be. There's something wrong with it. It being being seen. You know, it's something that it should be humiliated at. It is something that is true when you're super fat and whenever it's true covered up. But there's way too much. There's way too much. What is the term? Humilitus going on. And I believe the adults are being run by the little children. So yeah, I know. I think I said it like 3 times now. So what is that? I'm repeating myself 3 times, thrice? I don't know. Anyway, I'll try to be more like this, and relaxed, and remember that I'm human being first, animal, human being animal, and then from that species tree, somewhere along the line, all this clothing happened, and during that moment, after that, became all of these religions, and with all of those religions became finger pointing from children at you. Yeah. So who's controlling you? You know, who's controlling you? It seems like it. Well, I could mention it the 4th time now. Yeah. So anyway. Good luck to everybody. Oh my gosh, I love to eat pumpkin pie, and I love cherry pie, and I love pecan pie, and I love all of those pies. Gosh dang it, it's just incredible. You know, gosh dang. And we can just go back right away and blame my relatives for being the happy, what do we call them? Embargoists with the ships. Drake, he was there again. Drake was there again, bringing sugar. What a bad boy, bringing sugar. Yeah. Didn't need that. Didn't need all of these relatives, you know, harvesting it, grabbing it, taking it, and gosh dang it. Yeah, didn't need that. Yeah, we can make the pies and the cakes with all of these beautiful fruit sugars. And what is the other thing? I'm just disrespectful to our body. The other thing is the fruit sugars. Which ones? We'll go with pineapple and pears. For some reason, the pineapple sweet is really super sweet, and the pear juice is really super sweet. If you really need to really kick it up, there's the apple juice, but the pears. For some reason, yeah, it's just like a thick syrup. And you can go also with just the grape juice, the white grape juice. That's another super sweet. So all of those can be used with baking of pies and cakes. So you don't have to use the white sugar that's been It's gone through a process. It's not like taking it from the sugar cane any longer, you know, that you strip out and it has the. It's like that candy. They used to sell it at the store. You could just buy the sugar cane straight. No, it's not like that. That's the raw cane. Once it's gone through the granulation process, they've done things to it, the processing, that's extra harmful to the body. It's changed the molecule. Of it. It's changed the molecular structure of it. Maybe not the one molecule, but many of the molecules. And so in changing it, that's how come it makes it so ready for the body. And it strips into us, literally, like a strip mine. It goes right into our body too quick. So that's the danger of sugar, that's all. It's just the processing of it, because they overprocessed it. So you can have the white sugar. If it's not white sugar, it's the before that moment, you know what I mean? If it's not been processed. So, that's all. Yeah. Okay. Alright, try to calm down, everybody. Try to calm down about my body. Yeah. Yeah, I know it's immature. I'm immature. Oh, there is that. There is a meetup group that is a nudist one. Nudist one. And I also did find there are the meetup groups that are the photographers with the nude models. And I'm like, well, this is sounding like some kind of a creep show, a bunch of guys that give a bunch of nude women the photo. And I'm like, I don't know. It sounded too creepy to me. A bunch of, what do you call them, extra horny dudes that take Viagra or something and know how to click a camera. And women who are desperate. I guess I'm not going to join that group. I guess not, no. That sounds too horrible. So yeah, I like three or four of those, so I was kind of embarrassed for you guys. Actually, doesn't look good on site. Yeah, like I said earlier, I would prefer to be dropped off at the marina and I'll just find love there. Yeah.